Scoliosis is a condition in which there's something abnormal about the shape of a spine. So generally speaking, when you're looking at a spine from the front or back, it should be overall straight. And so traditionally, scoliosis is defined as any sideways curve to the spine, but a more broad term would be spine deformity. In adult scoliosis, the common thread among all of those different treatment strategies is correction of the shape of the spine to something more normal, more physiologic, we would say, and then stabilization of the spine in that better shape. Typically, these surgeries require implanting things like screws and rods and sometimes disc spacers, things like that, to bring the spine back to a more normal shape and hold it there. So in adults, the primary non-surgical treatment strategies are all approached at minimizing pain associated with the scoliosis or the spine deformity. And so those are things like physical therapy, injections. You can try wearing a brace. That can sometimes make people feel better, but it's never been shown to make a curve stop progressing or to become straighter. The risks today are far less than they ever were before. The more common things that happen after an adult scoliosis surgery are things like infection, pneumonia after surgery. People can also develop blood clots in their legs or lungs if they're having a hard time getting out of bed for a long time, and other medical complications that people are more prone to having in the weeks after surgery. The biggest and most important benefit of having surgery to treat adult scoliosis or any adult spine deformity is improved quality of life. Adult spine deformity is known to be one of the most debilitating conditions that people develop. Surgery stands to drastically improve somebody's quality of life. To prepare for a large scoliosis or spine deformity surgery is first and foremost to have a lengthy and detailed discussion with your surgeon about what to expect and what all the options are. And then secondly, it is to get medically optimized before surgery. So that means making sure you're well nourished. If you're using any nicotine, stopping all nicotine use before surgery. If there's any medication changes or things that your other doctors want to do before surgery, making sure all of those things are done leading up to surgery. One should expect a hospital stay. Usually that hospital stay ranges anywhere from 3 to 7 days. The first 2 days after a spine deformity operation are generally difficult, but it does get better. It's very common for me to hear from people 3 months after surgery that they're very glad they did it, they wish they'd done it sooner, but that it was harder to go through than they thought it would be. A reasonable goal is 60 to 90% improvement in your symptoms after surgery. Average is probably somewhere around 80 to 90%. Pain is a complex thing. It's hard to achieve 100% improvement with something as complex as pain. The best candidates for scoliosis surgery are people who have a symptomatic scoliosis or symptomatic spine deformity and don't have any medical conditions that would make surgery too dangerous to complete. That includes people with severe deformities. It includes progressive deformities and spine deformities that are very symptomatic. Curves that cause severe pain. Those kinds of spine deformities in combination with patients who don't have any medical complications or histories that would make surgery too dangerous for them, those tend to be the best candidates for surgery. The different kinds of scoliosis can affect different populations of people differently. The most common kind of scoliosis in teenagers more commonly affects females than males. People with certain neurological disorders, things like MS or multiple sclerosis or other neurological disorders, they're more prone to developing a neuromuscular scoliosis. Although there are no hard and fast rules about disqualifiers for spine deformity or scoliosis surgery, the most common ones that we see are conditions that significantly limit somebody's life expectancy. So for example, if somebody has end-stage cancer and they have a life expectancy that's a year or less, generally speaking, a large scoliosis correction surgery is probably not going to be in that person's favor. Scoliosis and spine deformity correction surgeries are generally more complex. These are bigger operations. There's more risk associated with them. it is important to see somebody who predominantly sees patients with spine deformity and scoliosis, and what those different pathways look like in terms of risks, benefits, quality of life, and what one can reasonably expect from that surgery.